The unanswered emails and messages sent to Shabil Ali. Who is Shabil Ali? Shabil Ali is a well-known debater, apologist, dawah guy, imam. He runs a dawah center in Toronto, which I had been to many times. I used to give out his tiny dawah flyers, the one-minute messages on Islam that he used to make. Go back to July 2015. I was in the process of questioning my faith. I was having doubts about whether the religion that I had converted to was actually true or not. I was in the process of speaking to people, of talking to everyone, of trying to challenge my new thoughts and ideas to see whether they made sense or not. You see, this is a type of situation when you lose your faith, when you're going from a conservative Muslim to a non-Muslim, everybody around you sees the difference. This didn't happen overnight, but it did happen quite quickly in my case. One of the steps of my journey was to reach out to all my friends, to post on Facebook, to find out if there were scholarly individuals who could help me with my doubts. One of my friends, whose name is Adnan, actually knew Shabil Ali's son, Ilyas Ali, and introduced me to him in a group chat on WhatsApp. So my friend Adnan, I'm not going to share his full name, he added me to this group. He's a kind soul. He said, "Assalamu alaikum, Ilyas. I want to connect you to Abdullah Samir. He had some questions and I suggested to reach out to you or your father. This group is merely to connect you. I may or may not stay in the group. By way of background, I met Abdullah Samir during my university days and is a really nice brother who is passionate about Islam but also research and questions things as well." So this is a friend of mine we met in university, and he introduced me to Shabil Ali's son, Ilyas Ali. And then I said, "Jazakallahu khaira," which means, "May Allah reward you, Adnan. Ilyas, I would like to speak to you or your dad about some questions I have that crept into my mind." Ilyas said, "Wa alaykum salam, Samir. Eid Mubarak. Sorry for my delay in responding. I'm happy to help as best I can. Do you want to share some or all of your questions here so I can forward them to my dad?" And then I went through a big discussion and I explained everything. One of the main topics was Alexander the Great romance and how similar it was to the story in the Quran, which was a problem because Alexander the Great is actually a Greek polytheist, not a Muslim, not a monotheist. Anyways, he said, "Okay, interesting question. I hadn't heard of the Alexander myth before. I'll pass the question to my dad. I'm interested to hear his answer as well." So he emailed his dad and he said, "Please see attached WhatsApp message conversation. I'm CCing Brother Abdullah Samir here. He's hoping you can answer this question. Let us know." And I said, "I'm going to be more helpful than that. I'm going to reformat this into a nice email because no one wants to go through this big long chat conversation. These are the strong arguments, and this is some articles that I would like you to review," right? And included Islam QA and some things about how the Quran talks about the heavens being held up by pillars you can't see and whatnot. Shabil Ali said, this is back in July 2015, when I first was doubting Islam, "Thanks for bringing this to my attention. I'll look into it and let you know my thoughts soon, inshallah, Shabil Ali. Jazakallahu khaira. I very much appreciate this," I said. I was actually looking forward to this. I was excited. I wanted to see what he was going to come up with. I also sent it to my wife, the email. And I also said, and then 1 year later, I decided to email Brother Ilyas, which is his son, and say, "Thank you so much for your help. I ended up leaving Islam." And I shared my blog. I was hoping that, you know, maybe he would gain some insight as well from reading it, right? And again, no response. So no response from Shabil Ali, no response from Ilyas. But then again, this was mainly for Shabil Ali, not for his son, right? And then finally, I emailed Shabil Ali in 2017 and I said, "Dear Shabil, here's my original email I sent to you when I left Islam as a reference." So I sent to him as a reference. And then I asked him, "Would you be interested to have a debate with me about whether Islam is true? Your son forwarded some doubts I had 2 years ago, but I didn't get a response. Anyway, somebody suggested I try reaching out to you for a debate. Would you be interested?" Now, some people thought, you know, I was asking for too much when I asked him for a debate. I was too forward. He was too famous. I was a nobody. But I thought, you know, let me give it a try. Let me give it a shot. You know, maybe he'd be interested in having a conversation. Maybe we can learn from each other. And maybe I'm totally wrong. So he'd be, you know, he'd get the benefit of like destroying my arguments in public. Now, Shabir Ali is actually known for debating Christians, not for debating atheists. So maybe this is outside of his comfort zone. Either way, I think Shabir Ali is a cool guy. I really like him. But I wanted to show you how this is kind of the experience that many ex-Muslims go through. We doubt Islam, we reach out, and a lot of times we don't get any answers from anybody. We just don't because there is no answers. The fact is that Islam doesn't stand up under scrutiny, which is why it all falls apart when you look into the details. And I had actually made a list of people that, of situations where this kept happening over and over again. I called it "Why Are Muslims Running Away," and it's a quite a long list, right? And there's a few situations where I actually managed to speak to Muslims, and I was very happy about that. And I indicated those few times there as well. It was quite difficult to convince Muslims to discuss with you in any way online, and that's basically the pattern that I've noticed. And I guess it's a strategy of like, you know, maybe if we ignore the problem, it'll go away. I don't know. Maybe it's like if we, you know, allow these people to have platforms, it will make them more popular. So it's better we just ignore them. Whatever the case, it is what it is. Alrighty, well, thanks for watching. Thanks for watching my story about Shabir Ali not responding. I honestly don't know what happened, but it is what it is. I left Islam. I don't think that there's actually any good answers to the questions I was asking, so I'm glad I left Islam. But stay tuned for more, and you know, subscribe and all that stuff as well, right? This is Abdullah Samir signing out.